We're going to go to the White House now, where President Trump is taking on the opioid crisis, invoking his own family's history with addiction.
I had a brother, Fred, great guy, best looking guy, best personality, much better than mine. But he had a problem. He had a problem with alcohol. And he would tell me, don't drink, don't drink. He would say it over and over and over again. And to this day, I've never had a drink.
Now, according to the CDC, 91 people die of opioid overdoses every day. Up to 29% of the people who are prescribed them for pain misuse their medication. And the economic burden of that abuse is more than $78 billion a year. Let's bring in our chief White House correspondent, John Carlin. John, the president is calling this a public health emergency, but he's facing some criticism for not declaring the more sweeping national emergency he promised.
He is, George, but this is a significant move, one that public health experts say can make a difference. It does allow for the reallocation of some federal funds towards treatment and prevention. It also makes it easier to obtain anti-addiction medication. And the president is promising to stem the flow of illegal fentanyl from China. This is something that he says that he will raise when he visits Beijing, raise it with the Chinese in November. The big question, though, is, will the president ask Congress for more funds to deal with all of this? I expect that he will, but there is no indication of how much.
Well, yeah, and he's already facing some criticism over that because his current budgets cut funding for places like the National Institute of Health, which fund opioid research and prevention programs.
Not to mention the changes he wanted in Medicaid, which is another source of funding to deal with this. And he's faced some criticism from some of his allies during the campaign because he did make this a big issue in the campaign.
Meantime, yesterday the House passed that budget, which sets the framework for those big tax cuts that the president is promising. A lot of indications now that the Republican leadership in the White House pushed very hard to get this done as quickly as possible, even though most members of Congress, most of the public, don't know the details of the plan yet.
Well, because the plan hasn't been released, and they're talking about getting it done by Thanksgiving. George, in the past, major tax bills have taken many months, if not years, to get done. This would be record time. One Republican said, speed kills. In other words, by doing this fast, they hope to kill any opposition to the plan.
Okay, John Carl, thanks.